All aboard as Lee Cowan shares a story of perseverance and giving back.
Connecticut's number 40. She's more than 100 years old, still with a fire in her belly that has her chugging her way through the Connecticut countryside to this day. Now that's determination. She's not unlike the little engine that could. That train in the children's classic that for more than 90 years has been teaching us that believing in ourselves can get us up and over life's rough spots. But let's back down that mountain for a second. While the mantra, I think I can, worked pretty well for the little blue engine, what about those who think they can't?
Working hard and believing yourself makes achieving your dreams possible, but not always probable.
Bob McKinnon is an author and adjunct professor who teaches classes on social mobility. And he's just written what he sees as a companion to the little engine that could, called Three Little Engines.
The station master called to the little blue engine, "You're up first, are you ready?" "Yes, ma'am," she replied, and off she went.
In his telling, the little blue engine does what she always does.
Up and up the little blue engine climbed, chugging, "I think I can, I think I can, I think I can."
But her friends, the fierce and confident yellow passenger engine and the strong and fiery red freight engine, don't have it as easy. They each encounter trouble on their tracks that, through no fault of their own, forces them to stop.
In the early parts of my life, I was the engines that got stuck. Like, I literally had things that would fall on my track, or the winds that were blowing me in the face, and I just got too tired to move on.
McKinnon grew up poor, raised by a single mom. No one in his family had ever been to college. McKinnon was the first, graduating from Penn State in 1990. But it was bittersweet.
I felt more guilty and more angry when I would look back and I'd see friends or family members that were struggling. I was angry at the system. I was angry at, like, how can we as a country that affords opportunities for some kids or some people and, you know, to do well, let so many down. And so I was frustrated that they were still struggling.
Granted, social mobility is a pretty weighty issue for kids, but McKinnon hopes to ease into the topic by teaching them that they each have their own rails to follow. They're not always equal, but accepting help is a sign of strength, not weakness.
You at one point actually sat down and made a list of all the people that had helped you along the way, and it ended up being a pretty long list.
Yeah, I can't tell you how good that made me feel, and how lucky and how blessed.
Have you ever been on one before?
First time.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
The whole Horatio Alger idea that grit and good moral character can improve our circumstances is as old as the Transcontinental Railroad itself. What's often overlooked, he says, is the role empathy and compassion play in success, too.
I guess if I had one wish, I would want people just to use it as an opportunity to really reflect on their journey.
McKinnon wrote the first draft of his idea in a pretty fitting place, a notebook his own children used for coloring and doodles.
This is the very first iteration of it?
Yep. Pardon my chicken scratch.
And you did this all in?
One sitting.
One sitting.
Finally, all three engines came rumbling down the mountain.
Sorry, spoiler alert, no tears here. There is a happy ending. All three made it up and over the mountain.
I liked how all the trains had their different personalities.
The plot twist? The little blue engine went back to help her friends. A gesture that had these little critics cheer.
Two thumbs up and a smiley face. That's pretty good.
We should all blow our own whistles whenever we get up and over a mountain. But real success is giving others that head of steam so that they can do it too.
It would be a very natural thing to just go like this, and I'm going to move forward. And what I would hope we would do is to do this, and to look around and see, all right, I'm okay, but how's everyone else doing?